Hello there, my crafty friends. It's Ashley Pfeiffer, the maker behind Stamped AF. I am an independent Stampin' Up! Demonstrator in Canada. And last week for my, I'd say live stream, my weekly live stream, except that it only went live on Facebook, I did a card destash. So I do this every couple of months. This was only the second time. I take my bucket full of cards that I've made since the last destash and go through them one by one, and the viewers basically call dibs on what they want. And this was one of the cards, and there were quite a few people that wanted this one, and I said, well, maybe I should do a video on this. Now, I know that I've done something with this card, but I think maybe it was for a team meeting. So I'm going to share this with you now, but I decided that as this video comes live to you, it will be May 31st, 2021. I thought to start June off, which is the last month of our mini catalog, I would do my weekly videos as like a catalog mashup. So I had the DSP and everything cut and prepared to do this card. And then I thought, wait a minute, let's stick with this bundle because it's only with us for another month. But let's change it up. So I am using some different DSP. Now I have a ton of the Fine Art Floral, but I was anxious to try this with the Elegantly Said. I want to say it's Elegantly Said. I will put the supplies below, but this is a great fun fold. I've gone ahead and I did all the die cutting already. Now, if you look in my bundle, it looks like a mess. I've got masks in here. I've got washi tape galore, but this is so that when I cut my flowers, I get the design and the cut all in one. And if I decide I just want one, I take that washi tape off. But I did go ahead and I did my die cutting already. So with these two flowers, it's very easy. It's one piece and then, whoops, you pop out the little inserts. But for the leaves, same idea. So I've got a little bit of washi tape on there and that's done. I think this has been a bit of a sleeper in the catalog. I haven't seen a whole lot done with it. It wasn't my cup of tea at the beginning, but I think there's some great potential. This threw me at first, but I think it's great if you do a repeating pattern. The font in here, or fonts, are lovely. It's a very elegant stamp set, and I mean, it'll go great with elegant DSP, right? So this is a 5.5 by 11 card base. So you're only going to get one from a sheet of cardstock. We're going to do some folding. So I scored this at 1¼, 4 inches, and 6¾ inches. Okay, and that is the basis. You know what? I should back the bus up. So let me show you this. This is the belly band. And we are going to do the belly band the same, just different colors. Well, all of it will be the same, but different colors. And then I put an additional panel on the back so that you could stamp and write your sentiment. So, and it's a nice loose belly band. So this piece is going to go on there. I know that's a lot of basic gray on basic gray. We could cut it and mat it, but I think I'm going to leave it as is. And then on my first card, I did two differing patterns here, but I thought this might be nice because it's got that pop of metallics. It might be nice to put both pieces on there because you're only going to see one from the front. Now you might be thinking, well, what about this paper on the back? That is going to be the very front thin panel. And you may be wondering why I'm using Stampin' Seal. Usually my adhesive of choice would be liquid glue. But when it's a thin DSP like this, I like to use Stampin' Seal because it's not visible with the glue. And I don't think it's just the way I do it. I think with a thin DSP like this, you're bound to see the glue. Now, should we do it like that? I think so. I think that was the way I cut it. So you just want to get an even border on all four sides. This card comes together quite quickly, especially because I had done some of that prep work before I pressed record. I find that some of the videos are just, they're too long. So I'm gonna cut it back. Not everyone. If you caught my video on Friday, it was part of a video hop, and it was making your own hockey jersey. And while I do speed up some parts that are repetitive or maybe go without saying, it needed to be a longer one because there was a lot of detail in there. Look how fast this comes together. And maybe we'll put a sentiment on the back. This will make a great masculine card. And I know I'm not the only one that struggles with masculine cards. I think we have so many floral stamp sets with Stampin' Up! That it can be tricky to do a masculine card, which was the point of this blog hop last week. So if you haven't seen it, you should go back and check it out. Look at that. Now we can take our belly band, and this is 1¼ by 11. It's obviously way too long. And instead of scoring it, what I like to do is just fold it down. You can use your bone folder to get a nice crease. Instead of trying to measure and figure out where it's going to fit nicely, just do it this way. It's foolproof. Now, once we get that off, we can crease it a little bit more. And if it bugs you that it's nice, not actually, that doesn't look bad, does it? But you could always emboss it if you find that that bugs you. Or just go ahead and score it. Now, I won't glue it together until I have my tag ready to go. And like I said, we don't need all of this. I like to cut it off of this part. Actually, let's glue it now. I'll set it under something to, like a weight to set it. You don't want it so tight that it doesn't slide. It's supposed to be a belly band. It's not permanent. Our tag, and I used one of the tags from the Hippo and Friends dies. You can use whatever tag you'd like. We've got our two foil flowers. I'm so sad that the silver foil retired because I think it would have been stunning with this to have both gold and silver. And if you have both in your stash, use them. Okay, so you can see that I used a full-size dimensional and I've got a little bit of adhesive there. We can use that to our benefit when it comes to adding an embellishment. I've got my two little leaves here that are in black. This is a very goth plant. And I believe when I did my first one, I did two, oh no, large, small. Probably doesn't matter which way they go, but let's just replicate it the way I did the first time. Let's use a gilded gem because I think that would just be the icing on top of this elegant cake. My foil doesn't want to stick. And if you are making this for a masculine card, maybe this doesn't work. You could use any other stamp set. I think I'm going to stick with wishing a lovely birthday to you. It's just so elegant. It's really the only word that I can think of for this. Should have been elegant petals. And funny story about the Elegantly Said bundle. I hesitated too long, and by the time I was convinced that I wanted it, it was on back order. So even if I wanted to use the coordinating suite to this DSP, I don't have it. Sorry, coordinating bundle. There we go. A little heavy on the birthday, but it's so pretty. Now, is there something we can do on the back? We could do, "I'm so happy you're my friend," but I think we'll just leave it. And then for the tag, I like to just put the glue on the belly band. But I go on the liberal side, or the conservative side, because I don't want to go too far. I think this would look good with silver leaves too. Okay, so I hope that whichever colorway you choose, you enjoyed this fun fold. It really is so easy, and I mean, I did a bit of the die cutting and prep beforehand, but it really comes together quickly, and this flower is stunning with all of its cutouts. The stamp set is stunning. You won't regret it. So you have less than a month. June 30th is when this catalog ends, and they're only guaranteed for a certain amount of time. So don't hesitate or you may miss out. If you are new here, I hope that, well, first off, I'm glad that you found me. And second, I hope that you enjoyed what you saw and will consider hitting that big subscribe button below. Catch a new video each and every week. And that is all, my crafty friends. If you have any questions, just leave me a comment and I will get to it as soon as I can. And we'll see you soon, my crafty friends. Bye.